children, welcome to yet another science class, and this is your second class. In this lesson, we are learning about respiration in organism. So, in the first class, we have known different things about respiration. What is respiration? Usually, we think that breathing is called respiration. No, respiration has two steps. One is called breathing and another one is called cellular respiration. This we have seen in the last class. Okay, now in this lesson we are going to learn about the entire parts involved in the respiration process. So now here we have a term called system. What is system? Now we are going to learn about respiratory system. System means group of organs. Say if I say lungs, it is one organ. If I say trachea, it is one organ. If I say nose, it is one organ. But these all organs are related with the respiratory process. These all organs are doing one particular work called intake of oxygen, and from that oxygen, using that oxygen, breaking down the food. Each and every part takes different role. So now all these organs doing this respiratory work alone are collectively called as respiratory system. So like this, in our body we have so many system: digestive system, excretory system, skeletal system. If we say the term system, it involves one particular function, different organs joined together and doing that function. Okay, so as per that, in today's lesson we are going to learn about respiratory system, which means what are the different organs involved in the respiratory function and where they are located. So now usually you can divide it into external part and internal part. External part you would have seen very well, nose. So through the nose is the first external part which this respiration process is starting. Now you know very well, we all have two holes in the nose. The two holes are called nostrils. What is the term? Nostrils. The entire structure is called nose. The hole present inside the nose is called nostrils. Now from this nostril, there will be a broader structure which is connecting both upper side of the respiratory part and the lower side of the mouth part and coming down. Now this area is called nasal cavity. Nasal cavity means place. The place where this nose related things are present, that is called nasal cavity. And this bend region where it bend, that is the upper side is near the mouth and the nose and the lower side comes inside deep, this is called pharynx. What is this? Pharynx. Now this pharynx leads into a tubular structure through which the air is passing. This structure is called trachea. I will explain you the functions one by one later after finishing the entire diagram. Now this structure is called trachea, otherwise we can call it as windpipe. In lower class you could have learnt as windpipe. Now you are in higher class, so you have to use the technical scientific term. So the name of the windpipe is trachea. Now this trachea will come and divide into two different branches. The single trachea will come down and divide into two different branches. This is called bronchi. B-R-O-N-C-H-I, bronchi. Bronchi is a plural term, in singular bronchus. If you remove I and add U-S, it is singular, it will represent only one side. Now since it is present in both the side, we can call it as bronchi. And this bronchi is covered with a structure called lungs. So this is called lungs. Now this lung is made up of upper lobe and lower lobe. Okay, now if you come inside this bronchi, again you can see many branches. How the branches of root is coming, you could have seen in the trees, right? When you see the root, one main branch, and from that again branches. Even in the leaves you can see the branches. These branches are called bronchioles. Bronchioles. So now from the pharynx, trachea, from trachea two branches called bronchi, and the bronchi again divide into many branches called bronchioles. And finally each and every bronchiole will have a air like structure. Now while I explain, listen very carefully. These explanation only are going to become your questions. So if you understand the parts and its function, easily you can write the answers in your classwork without me giving the notes, without referring the textbook even. Okay, listen very carefully. So as I told you, pharynx, trachea, it is dividing into two branches called bronchi, and this bronchi again getting into several many branches called bronchioles. And the bronchioles at last they have a bag like structures called alveoli. What is this? Alveoli. This is bag like structure. Okay, and here we have a separate structure called diaphragm. Actually diaphragm is not the main one of the part of the respiratory system, but when respiration process happen, this diaphragm has a role. So I have given. Okay, so now we will learn the functions of each and every respiratory organ. So respiratory system involves the main parts called first nose, then nostrils, from nostrils nasal cavity, from nasal cavity to pharynx, then pharynx lead to trachea. Trachea is otherwise called windpipe, and trachea is divided into two branches called bronchi. Bronchus is a singular term, bronchi is a plural term, and again this bronchi, they are getting divided into many branches called bronchioles, and again this bronchioles are getting the end with the air bag called alveoli, and at last we have diaphragm. What is the function of the nose? Nose is the organ which allow the external air into the respiratory system. Now what and all will be there in the external air? There may be any wastes mixed okay, see all dust particles, any chemicals kind of waste, dust particles and all mixed, then there may be germs, okay, microorganisms. And if you, it is summer season, the air may be very hot. If it is winter season, it may be very cold. But as such, if this waste, dust and the germ containing hot or cold air, if it goes into the lungs, it will disturb, spoil the lungs. See, you could have known, those who smoke, okay, who smoke cigarette, they will get lung disease. What is the meaning? When they smoke more cigarette, all the chemicals go through the nostrils and settle down in the lungs. Now, the cigarette consists of so much of unwanted chemicals where our nostrils cannot stop it. That is the problem. Now, we will see the main function of the nostrils. Inside the nose, we have two holes called nostrils. And here, if you touch, you can see there are small air-like structures inside the nostrils. The function of this air is removing the dust. So inside the nostrils, we have small hair-like structures, and the hairs, when air enter into the nose, they will filter, how, you know, your mom will filter tea, right? Just like that, the dust present in the air will be filtered by the hairs present inside the nostrils, and the air without the dust will enter into the nose. Again, this cavity, this area will have mucus, a liquid. See, that is what, when you get cold, you get some liquid from your nose, right? What is the meaning is, if so much of unwanted germs enters into our body will try to throw it out through the mucus liquid, which is called this mucus, and that will remove the germs. So finally, the blood vessels, there are so many blood vessels surrounding this nostrils, and that blood will pump blood which is hot or cold depending upon the climate. Suppose if the external climate is so cold, chill air enters into the nose, immediately that blood will show hot on this nostrils and the air will become little hot. Then that heated air alone will enter into the nostrils. Now, as per this, if you see your nostrils will filter different types of materials. First, we have hair, which filter dust. Then we have mucus, which filters germs. Then we have blood vessels, which warmth or cold, giving cold to the air. So finally, the waste, dust containing, germs containing hot or cold air from the atmosphere, when they enter into the nose and to the nostrils, when they enter inside the lungs, they will enter as clean, okay, very clean, germ-free, moist, warmth air. Got it? See, the small holes, nostrils does that much work. It has hair to remove the dust, mucus to remove the germs and also give the wetness to the air, blood vessels to give warmth to the air. Finally, the air is cleaned with little moist and with hot or cold condition it enter into the nasal cavity. Now what is the role of pharynx? Pharynx is the connective link between the external upper part of the respiratory system and the lower part of the respiratory system. Here we have another organ called larynx, which is otherwise called voice box. And here we have a cover like structure which will open and close now and then. See, when we have a single opening here in the pharynx region from your mouth and nostrils, common opening. See, this is a line from the mouth and here from the nose. This is nose, this is mouth. Here we have a common opening, but after sometimes trachea one side, food pipe one side will go. Okay, so the food what you eat will come here and go into the food pipe. The air what you inhale will come here and go into the trachea. But they both will meet in the mid place called pharynx region. Because of that only there we have a cover like structure. What will happen? Here the cover like structure will be there. When the air enters, this cover like structure will come and close the food pipe. So the air will straight away go inside the trachea, that is windpipe. Again when we eat, automatically this cover will open from the mouth, that is food pipe, and turn towards this windpipe and close the windpipe. So when you eat the food, it will not go to the windpipe, it will straight away enter into the food pipe. This is one important work of the pharynx region. Then it is linked to the next place called trachea. Trachea is nothing, a tube through which this air enters into the lungs. Again, when the trachea divides into two branches, the collected air is poured into both the lungs through this bronchi. This bronchi divides, splits. Suppose say 100% of air comes, 50% will go this side, 50% will go that side. Then again, the air through the bronchi will enter into the bronchioles. Bronchioles again will go, leave the air into the alveoli. So this is the final step. The air which you take through the nose will pass through all these parts and enter into the alveoli. Here in alveoli only the cellular respiration will take place. So already in the last class we have seen respiration has two steps called breathing and cellular respiration. So till you take the air and here cleaning takes place, it is passing through the trachea, crossing the bronchi, bronchioles, reaching the alveoli. Till reaching the alveoli, that is called breathing. The second step, cellular respiration, takes place in the alveoli, because each and every alveoli will have connection with the blood vessels. Then here the exchange of gases will take place from the blood vessels. Waste carbon dioxide will go to the alveoli. From the alveoli, from the collected air, oxygen will enter into the blood vessels. So while you inhale, you are inhaling oxygen, and the oxygen comes through this way into the last alveoli part. From the alveoli it enter into the blood, and blood do many work. No, it is dividing food. In the first class we have seen respiration is nothing but dividing the food and releasing energy. So when the digestion process over, the food will go stay in the blood. Whenever we work, whenever we need energy, immediately the blood will have oxygen also. One oxygen will be going near the food, it will cut the food and take the energy to do the work. While cutting the food, water and carbon dioxide will be released. That carbon dioxide alone coming here and entering into the alveoli again. So now we have another thing called diaphragm. What is diaphragm? See, when we breathe, okay, when the air comes inside, the air go press, it will press the lower part where we have stomach. So the stomach and all should not get any problem. To avoid this, we have a layer between the lower part, that is stomach, and the upper part, lungs, that is called diaphragm. So when the air comes, the diaphragm will go down. Again, when the air go out, the diaphragm will go up. So with this we can wind up our class. Now let us go for the homework. Now I'll rub this and write homework, and the homework is completely depending upon this explanation. So just if you again and again repeatedly see the video, you can write answers. Now you are going to write in your classwork. Okay, last class I have given only activity, I have not given writing work. Now you are going to write in the classwork. Note down the questions properly, and if you listen to class, you can write the answers straight away by your own, or you can go through, read the textbook and find the answers. Okay, the first question is, draw the structure, draw the structure of respiratory system and name the parts. So first you have to draw the structure of the respiratory system and name the part. Listen carefully, the respiratory system diagram is there in your book, but it is not having few parts like bronchus, bronchioles and alveoli. I want all those parts. So you have to draw the diagram by seeing the book and listen my video. Whatever parts I have mentioned in the class, that you have to catch and copy it in your diagram. Okay, and the second question is, what are the two steps involved in the respiration process? What are the two steps involved in the respiration process? Breathing and cellular respiration, that you can write as a answer. Now again, name the various organs present in the respiratory system. So again, already you have drawn and you have written parts. Now you have to write only the parts without the diagram. And question number 4, write the functions of nose and nostrils. See, while explaining, at last I have drawn one diagram, nostrils, one line, hair, mucus, blood vessels, and below that dust particles, after that germs. That diagram structure you have to draw and explain in depth. What is the role of hair, what is the role of mucus, that you have to explain. And the last question is, define bronchus, bronchioles and alveoli. Define means you must tell in one line what is that. Say bronchus means it is a branch which comes out from the trachea, which allow the air to pass through it. You can write like that. Bronchioles means it is a branch which comes out from the bronchus. The air comes through the trachea, enter into the bronchus and it enter into the bronchioles. You can write like that. And alveoli, what is alveoli? Define alveoli. Alveoli is a bag-like structure present at the end of the bronchioles. You can write like that. Okay, you have to explain what it is. That is called define. So children, I hope you would have understood today's class properly. You should know all the parts thoroughly and you should know the functions very thoroughly, because this is the basic for your higher classes. Based on this function, based on these names of the organs, till your college you're going to study so many things. So you have to be very, very thorough with all these parts. Okay? Thank you. We'll meet in the next class.